instinct, I picked up one of my father's flute and started playing. And my grandfather was listening to it, thought my father is playing. And when he came out and saw me playing, he was shocked. So when my father came home in the evening, my grandfather told him that this boy can play the flute. So my father asked me to play, and I played. He was very happy. Then my father thought that I have some talent, so I must be taught. So he gave me initial lessons, and when he found me good, he thought of taking me to his guru, Pannalal Ghosh, who is a legend in flute playing. In my school, when people, teachers learned that I'm learning from Pannalal Ghosh, they were all awed by my listening. And then I heard stories about Pannalal Ghosh, and then he became my hero. He got a job in All India Radio as an orchestra conductor. So he went to Delhi, and he died there only in 1960. When he died, my father decided that he should not play flute anymore because there is no equivalent to his guru. So my lessons were stopped. That carried on for more than 3 years. Then my father thought that my talent would go west if I don't pursue this music. So he was suggesting me that I should go to, there are 2-3 disciples of Pannalal Ghosh. But somehow, even I was a child, I never could compromise Pannalal Ghosh's music with anybody else. One of my cousins who used to come for practice with tabla on me, with me, he was a vocalist, and he suggested that I should go to his teacher, a very well-known man and very learned man, Chidanand Nagarkar, who was a principal of Bharati Vidya Bhavan. So I went there and started learning from him. He told me, Nityanand, learn from me, I'll make you so big that people will forget Pannalal Ghosh. And that hurt me a lot. So I stopped going to him. Devendra Murdeshwar, son-in-law of Pannalal Ghosh, came from Delhi to Bombay. I met him there and requested him that I want to learn again. But that time I had a facial paralysis. My face was crooked, I mean, left side totally gone. Out of PT, he said, okay, come and learn. And that was a kind of a spark in me, which ignited that desire to learn music again. And I overcame my defect and started playing again. Yeah, there was one chance to meet my present guru, Annapurnaji. Pannalal Ghosh's daughter wanted to see her and take her blessings. And I was the person who took them to Annapurnaji's house. That was the first time I entered her house. And after meeting her and taking her blessing, we all went out. On our way back home, she told me, Nityanand, every artist has a wall in front of him. He faces a wall. And whenever you feel that you are facing a wall, you should break, want to break that wall, then you should come to her. Since that moment only I realized that I was facing a wall. And I wanted to break that house, so my urge was very strong. But my affection to my guru was so strong that I didn't want to go leave my guru and go to her to learn. So I kept it aside. After the demise of Devendra Murdeshwar's wife, Pannalal Ghosh's daughter, I was frustrated. Then I had decided to take lessons from her, Annapurnaji. And I was trying very hard to meet her, which was, a big task then. It took me almost 13 years to see her. But finally, when I went there, I was just thinking that well, I have learned this rag, I know this rag, I know this rag, this rag, this rag, everything I know, I will go and learn from her that rag, which, a chop rag, which nobody plays, or no. That kind of thinking I had when I went to her. The first day, she told me to play, and then started my first lesson in rag Yaman, the basic rag, which I had learned from all the gurus for a number of years, and which I thought that I could play the best. And then I realized that I was standing in front of a Himalaya. I was a very tiny creature in front of that. I don't know my music. That's what a feeling I got from her when I sat with her and learned the rag. And I was very sincere that time. I felt very inside my heart that, well, I don't know anything in music. I was humbled so much. That learning of that rag, which you know nobody plays, that idea went off my mind, and just thought of learning Yaman from her again. It's a fact that she was a much, much superior player to her husband, Pandit Ravi Shankar ji. Whenever they played, she used to get more applause, and then naturally the male ego always hurts, you know, and then the clashes and arguments. On her own, she stopped playing in the public. See, the music, the quality of music, that serenity in that, the devotion in that, the effect of that music was so much that you are floored. It's like come like an avalanche on you. So powerful, such powerful music. And I really wonder if she had to play in public, what would happen to the audience? If such kind of intensive music, it's so much powerful, people have missed it.